Let's see if they're in Elm's Reach. I don't want to miss this undead invasion thing, though. Let's check these homes, I guess. There must be a quest we completed.
Hiravias. Do people treat you badly because of how you look?
Are you kidding me? My face looks like a cautionary tale about the dangers of wild animals, and I'm even shorter than other Orlans my age. People just like to heckle me.
Don't ever let them. Be proud of who you are. They're the ones who should feel shame.
That's right. I know what that has to do with. Matter concerns the tribes, not the foreigners. That's the quest from the crap. I can't remember the names of anything. Let's just see if this druid's in here. No, these are just plain old. Okay. It has to do with the Hall of Warriors. We were supposed to retrieve this baby. Maybe we should put the baby back now. I've got this home as well. This is empty. The only thing I could think of, well, there's a bunch of druids in the Golden Grove, so yeah, maybe I should check there first. A whisper among the others, Arona lives no more. Could it be this blood up person?
Many blessings, traveler.
She clucks in sympathy. How's your friend doing? Losing an animal like that is hard. I'd like to see your wares as the only other. Yeah. Okay. Isold, maybe?
Hail, Estramore.
Do you seek the wisdom of our herbalist, or simply to bask in Waretha's glory? I'm going to completely ignore your question and say, what will the Ovates do now that Arona is gone? She lowers her head. That's unclear. Arona's passing has shown us the perils of leadership, even when authority is as benevolent as hers. She looks on at the kith gathered in the grove. Most of us became Ovates so that we wouldn't be shackled to the whims of a god. Some of us has questioned what it means to elevate another as we did Arona. Like, where are you guys going? You know, I think if there's a druid, would be here. Maybe Tamarin?
Hail, Estramore.
Though his eyes are closed and his posture still, the man before you keeps his head aimed at you, as if carefully following your movements. Hail to you. May your time in the Golden Grove be enriching. And hail to you, Autumn Orlin, the man says with a bow to Hiravias. Okay, here we go. Hiravias' eye widens in surprise, and his one good ear stands on end. How on Eora did you... The man's eyes remain closed, and he says with a smile, "Tranquility begets a receptive mind." He opens his eyes, revealing brown irises clouded with the beginnings of cataracts. "With my eyes open, I see your birth form, but when I look inward," and with this he closes his eyes again, "I see the autumn Stelgar." My friend is looking for more information about his spirit form. Tell us more. Tamrin smiles. His eyes remain closed. "I know the beast is often sent by Galloway as a sort of trial. Many Anamphaths are tested by the Autumn Stelgar. Those bested and consumed by the beast have their soul torn from their bodies and lost for all time." "So, my tribesmen were right?" Hiravias looks crestfallen. His posture slumps. His gaze drops to the ground. "Are you saying I have such terrible power? This must be some sort of... If your spirit form were a bee, would you be mystically compelled to make honey? Were it a bird, would you spend all day making nests?" Tamrin opens his eyes once more and looks Hiravias up and down before wincing and shutting his eyes once more. "I am saying this is what the animal your form resembles is known to do. It seems you are eager to leap to your own conclusions." "I would not normally advise one to speak with the circle at Blood Sands, but given your circumstances, the ethic knoll may prove of insightful." "These guys are the ethic knoll?" He turns and, with his eyes still closed, points to the northwest. "Read the stone slabs carved by the druids of the Blood Sands. There are answers to be found, as well as more questions, but you must explore them for yourself." The northwest, the Blood Sands. What exactly is written on these stones? "Much of it is utter rubbish on the incessant need for sacrifice." His calm countenance wavers as he says that last word with a spit and a hiss. "But amongst the dogma are a few bits of wisdom on Galloway. Your friend will understand." "Is there any more you can tell us?" "Only to trust in Galloway and trust in Whale. Both have blessed you in their own difficult ways." "I appreciate the attempt to lift my spirits," Hiravias grumbles, "but that doesn't really help." He sighs and digs into his ear stump with his index finger. "But he has a point. I shall trust Whale has something to show me in the Blood Sands." Let's get going. We spoke with Tamrin, an Ovate of the Golden, in Twin Elms. He was able to sense Hiravias' connection to the Autumn Stelgar. Tamrin reluctantly suggests that we travel to the Blood Sands and read the stone tablets carved into the cavernous expanse. He hinted that the tablets contain information of great use to Hiravias. Why do I not remember these Blood Sands? I'm, like, forgetting everything here? Oh, in there! Haven't I been there? Did I kill everyone in there? Yeah, these are the people who wanted us to take that baby. Two days, 16 hours. Tablets. These? No? Oh, this. Essence taken...
Upon Burial Isle, the two men meet again for the first time. though it was the last thing they did. The many-colored beast rent them both asunder. They were, in death, merged and made whole again.
Okay, guy.
Cute story. Two guys meet in the belly of a soul-eating creature. Maybe someday I'll eat two of the most insipid deer wooden lumberjacks, and they'll spend an eternity discussing beer whilst haunting my colon.
Perhaps the idea is that the Autumn Stelgar might not really destroy the souls. That could be true, he mutters. But I guess I don't know what to make of this. I've never, knowingly at least, eaten anyone's soul. Maybe it's a trick I've yet to learn. Lucky me. Still, I have a hard time believing that me spirit shifting and mauling anyone is going to make anybody whole again, despite what this tablet says. I'd like to look at the other tablets and see what they have to say. Okay. We discovered a stone tablet that told of two men meeting at Burial Island being reunited by way of being eaten by an Autumn Stelgar. Okay, I'm guessing these other tablets are in... Well, here's one here. No, that's not one we can look at. Okay, I'm guessing there's another one here. There might be one there too, but... And singe the flesh off our face here. There's nothing to see here but that pit. Alright. Sit over here. The blood of sacrifice waters the soil.
As souls split into multitudes, many lives come from one. The truest of power comes from sacrificing the shard to return its strength to the mother stone.
Hiravias says with dramatic gusto as he reads the Glamfellen ruins from the tablet.
The many lives from one sounds familiar. I was taught that sometimes between death and rebirth, a soul splits perfectly in two, creating two viable souls from one. Sounds strange, but it makes sense when you think about how the population has risen in generations. It's kind of a mathematical necessity that some process like this is happening.
So why did Whale lead you to this tablet? He scratches at his ear stump as his gaze drags along the floor. If that druid really wanted me to see this tablet, and if Whale really is guiding my quest for knowledge, there's someone out there who has the same soul past as me? So what? That's probably true of most of us. I just can't shake the fear that I'm the shard and my destiny is to be fed to something greater. Hiravias stares at you, wide-eyed and silent for several moments. Guess worrying won't do me any good. Let's read those other tablets. A stone tablet in the blood sand spoke cryptically of souls splitting over the ages, one soul slowly becoming split into many. Sorry, guys. into many. The tablet also hinted that great power comes from merging souls that were once split from the same origin. Let's speed this up a little. We'll try here. This might be the last tablet, I'm not sure. Maybe up here? Streaks of blood. I guess there's no tablet we can read here. I guess these don't count. Alright. Nothing over here. I'm not sure where else. Maybe here? I see a tablet there. Don't bother reading
it. Is not the water sacrificed unto the plant, and the plant sacrificed unto livestock, and livestock unto man? When the lesser soul is sacrificed to strengthen the greater soul, the whole of our family grows stronger. I suppose I get the argument. We all have to kill and eat, constantly for that matter, to live. This sounds like it's talking about the Blood Sands rituals. I wonder how, or even if, this is relevant to me.
Have you considered that the Autumn Stelgar may have been sacrificed to you, that Galloway was making you stronger? His good ear stiffens while his mangled ear twitches and shakes. It hadn't occurred to me, but I did win the fight. If Galloway were truly displeased with me, I can't imagine I'd have walked away from that trial alive. I don't know. Just sounds like they're trying to justify their practices of killing people. Come on, let's see what the other tablets have to say. Hiravias read from a stone tablet that spoke of human sacrifice. Likening the process to feeding plants to animals and animals to people, the inscription unnerved Hiravias. Possibly here? I don't know where the other tablets are. I forgot to have my, what do you call it on? Okay, there's no tablets here. Let's search manually for this one. Can I zoom in? No. Not sure where the other tablets would be. Tablet in here. Aha!
Each generation, the Anumphoth must stand before the autumnal beast in judgment. The wise endure, passing on their strength. The weak are eaten. Their souls ripped to pieces and lost for all time, removing such weakness from the cycle.
Hiravias reads from the Glamfellen text. He coughs uncomfortably and continues.
Well, I guess maybe my tribe wasn't entirely wrong about my spirit form being some sort of soul terror. I suppose I was hoping to hear a different answer on the matter, but...
He shrugs, his arms slumped to his sides. Laughing at number two. You seem so sad to have the spirit form of such a legendary beast. Don't tell me you never wished for power like that. His face becomes a scowl and he aims one eye at you. Oops. If it meant not being ostracized, I'd have spirit shifted into a mound of weasel droppings. His anger subsides and he looks at you for a long moment as he attempts to put his words together. You make a fine point. I did pray to Galloway for assistance in being a better hunter. I guess you got your wish. He lets out a long sigh and relaxes. For years I've been telling myself my tribe judged me unfairly. Guess they weren't completely wrong. So that other tablet mentioned Burial Isle, and another spoke of souls splitting over time and sacrificing, being some counter to this. Are you rethinking your opinion of Galloween's gift to you? His face squirms and he rocks his head side to side. Well, yes, and no. His fists ball up and he releases a long sigh. Yeah, this puts a lot of things into perspective. If you take a step back from it, Galloween must be having a great laugh over how slow a study I am to learn his lessons. I doubt any of this knowledge will change the opinions of my home tribe, and having met some of the other druidic practices out there, I think I'd rather remain a drifter. So what now? Adding it up, I want to head to the Burial Isle. The name was mentioned in the tablets, and it's implied there might be other Autumn Stelgars there. I did not want to hear verification that the Autumn Stelgar was such a terrifying monster, but I am thankful to Whale for bringing me to these tablets. The truth is valuable, especially when it is painful. Do you want a rematch with the Autumn Stelgar? Not exactly. I'm older, wiser, and stronger than when we last tussled, but, I can't really afford to lose any more eyes or ears. I'm fresh out of redundant organs. Hiravias read the parable written on the stones of the Blood Sands. The story spoke of the Autumn Stelgar being sent to test Anamphatha of their worth. Those that fail are consumed by the Stelgar so that their weakness does not live on and multiply. The tablets also mentioned that many Anamphatha would travel to Burial Isle to meditate and be tested by these Autumn Stelgars. Hiravias now wishes to explore the Burial Isle for one of these pilgrimage sites. I think I know where that is. Question is, do we have time? Before the undead. Yeah, before the undead, what do you call it? Attack our stronghold. I'm trying to wrap up this quest before that happens. Of course, we need travel time back. Oh, do we still have... Oh, hey. The chapel's done. I didn't even realize that. Oh, yeah, I heard that sound when someone was talking. The forum. That's our second to last thing. 2 days and 13 hours, so... To get back... It takes a day and 19 hours. To get to Burial Isle... We've been there. It takes an hour to get... Okay. I hope my save isn't gone. I moved on from that pit. So at that point I had explored all of Burial Isle. Maybe I have to do that over again.
Hail, Estramore.
take me across.